there were the H2 had two faces. Well, before I forget, Gorer died before he could get his Nobel Prize. I think he would have gotten it if he lived long enough. George Snell got the prize, and I think it was one of the most deserved prizes that the committee in Stockholm awarded. I might say later why I think so. Anyway, so they went a little bit different ways, but eventually they again came together. But in the meantime, several other of us became interested. So there I mentioned already Jack Stimpfling. Jack Stimpfling worked with Snell for a while and then became independent and continued the H2 work. Then there was Bernard Amos, who worked with Gorer for a time and published some important papers on H2 with him, and Hecker, who worked with both Gorer and Snell. So these were the people who were at the very beginning of the H2. And then there was the so-called Prague School of Immunogenetics. As I said before, when I came to the institute, there were two directions of the institute, Hašek's institute. One was immunological, purely immunological, and the other was tumor biology, viral tumor biology. Pavel was fiddling with the blood groups in rabbits, but eventually gave it up, and I began to work on the H2. Then a few others joined us. Pavel became interested in H2, and so that we formed a group that in the West was for a time referred to Prague School of Immunogenetics. Ivan Hilgard was trying heroically, I would say, to chemically isolate and identify the H2 antigens. I didn't get, unfortunately, to the right goal. It turned out to be very difficult because they were part of the membrane, so it was difficult to get them out of the membrane. Then there was Alena Lengerova and a few others. Peter Demand joined Pavel Ivani a little bit later. But there was a group of us who were in some way concentrated in their interest on the H2 primarily, but each of us a little bit different angle, and each of us with some different approaches to the H2.